Oh no, now I have knots in my rope. So I'm going to start as before, initially ascending the rope until I get to the first knot. So I'm ascending. The first knot I'm going to get to, clearly, is the knot at my ASAP. So what I need to be able to do is remove my ASAP while remaining safe and maintaining 2 points of contact. I'm going to tie an alpine butterfly below my ASAP. And I'll attach my dynamic cow's tail or tether, making it nice and short because I'm not far off the ground here. So this has given me a second attachment point to my backup rope. This means it's now safe for me to take my ASAP off. My ASAP has now managed to cross the knot. I'll put my tether away. Remove the knot that I put in. And continue ascending. I've reached another knot here. And at this point, I'm going to be very tempted to remove my hand ascender and just put it to the other side of the knot. I'm currently suspended just fine. I've got absolutely no risk of fall. This technique isn't best practice, but it's adequate practice. However, let's look at what happens in a moment. Continue climbing. Now my chest ascender is at the knot, and I need to move my chest ascender above the knot. At this point, I could stand up in my leg loops, remove my chest ascender, and place it above the knot. However, in doing that, I'm risking a fall onto my hand ascender, a fall onto a toothed device, and that's something that I want to avoid the risk of wherever possible. I'm not going to outright say that you should never approach a knot pass in that way. I certainly have in the past, and I'm sure there will be situations in the future where I will, but it's absolutely not best practice. Instead, I'm going to move on to my descender below the knot, below my chest descender. At this point, I'll slide my hand descender up a little more, make sure my ASAP's nice and high, and I'm going to remove my chesty. So now, if I sit down, if I fall, I'm confident that my weight is going to be taken by the ID. At this point, I will happily stand up and connect my ID. And I can continue on my way. In fact, before continuing on my way, should remove the rope from my ID. Good to go. Now I'm going to change to descent and let's look at crossing a knot on the way down. Let me get a little bit higher first. Okay, so now I'm on my way down and I'm approaching a knot. I don't want to abseil directly into my knot, that's going to make my life difficult. Now, again, descending over a knot, descend not quite to the knot, and I'm going to transition to ascenders. Take my ID off. And I'm going to attach my ID below the knot. So now I'm going to use my ascenders to down climb the rope until I'm closer to my knot. so that I'm able to take my senders off and sit on my ID without getting caught up on my hand ascender tether, like we showed earlier. So now I am very close to my knot. I'm going to take my chest ascender off and sit on my descender. Now I can take my hand ascender off. I've passed the knot. Coming back down. Finally, I need to get my ASAP across the knot, and the technique here is exactly the reverse of what we saw before. So I'm going to tie an alpine butterfly below the knot, attach my adjustable tether to the alpine butterfly, remove my tether, remove the knot, and continue on my way. And that's it for today. Those are the fundamentals of vertical mobility. As we said, in forthcoming videos, we'll have a look at areas of these techniques where many operators have room to improve their efficiency. We'll walk through those in detail.